God watching over me. The devil probably spy on me. I've been going through some. Kenneth, keep an eye on me. I know it's been a drought, but to my fans, don't go dry on me. If you want a picture, take a picture. Don't get shy on me. I'm here to inspire. I admire that you admire me. I've been in the dark, but I promise you'll see a bite of me. I'm sorry. To all my supporters, man. I love y'all. I just want to say thank you for supporting me since day one. You don't want to see me win, man. I don't know why, but we gonna win anyway. I came straight out the with a microphone. Boy, I swear I couldn't leave that mic alone. Everybody clear the room, I like to write alone. I'm in my zone, bass bouncing off the styrofoam. I'm never in between, I'm either hot or cold. Can't be a loser, I maneuver like I got a clone. I'm out here in these streets like I ain't got a home. And you barely hear from me like I ain't got a phone. Because there's no days off, there's no days.
All right, much appreciated, Coach, as we welcome all of you to our exclusive coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. We thought the old place was loud. Somehow this place got even louder a short time ago as the Falcons were introduced to this sellout crowd. We're set to go as the Falcons get ready to match up with the New England Patriots. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line. Just across the 25.
Let's go. 21. Gun, gun. Go.
On first down, Ryan eluding the pressure right. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And no, incomplete. Boy, they took a shot there on the first play, tried to start it out with a bang, but it's second down.
Well, that certainly looked like something that they discussed all week in practice, getting ready for this one. Take the big shot right out of the gate. At worst, you'll open up the defense a little bit, loosen them up, have them back on their heels.
Once again, they'll come up on the 26-yard line, second and 10. And the play clock running very low, so Dan Quinn decides to call for a timeout. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Throwing again. Ryan. The Pats are going to get there. Down he goes. Well, there was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving them exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
And now maybe they want some extra time to talk about this third and long play as we'll get a timeout. And that's their second charge timeout here in this first quarter. They're down to one remaining. And I don't think this is the script they had in mind for their opening drive. This is third and long.
Hey, wait. 11. Gun.
From the gun, it's Ryan. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jason McCourty. And he will take this down to the 10-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
suddenly it's first and goal after the interception. A quick change in the situation here. Feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. And he had a nice play there from his free safety position to hold him to nothing.
And Brandon, remember when the free safety was always back away from the line of scrimmage?
That's changed.
They all has that changed in a big way. The way we see it now, they're almost mirrors between the free safety and the strong safety. One will be up, one will be back, or sometimes both will be in the same spot. On that play, the free safety was there, no gain.
They go play action for White. Now it's Brady. The quick slant caught. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Patriot touchdown. Chris Hogan from 10 yards out. And the Pats have taken the early lead. Gostkowski with the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. Gostkowski now out to kick it away. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. Ryan and the Falcons now come up first and 10 at their own 24.
Hey, express, express. 11. What is that?
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. He completes it to Julio Jones. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First play of the drive, a success, 19 yards. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10.
20.
On first and 10, it's Ryan. The throw to the left side, caught by Coleman. And a pretty little juke move there on a nice game. It's a 9-yard pickup on the play, and it'll be second and about a yard. Out of the gun, it's Ryan. Flushed out right. Man open, that's Calvin Ridley. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. That one goes for 36 yards.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up second down.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. And he goes down. It's a Patriot sack. John Simon. In there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
Hey, got it. Hey, South. Hey, Space. Hey, Express.
Third and long. It's Ryan. Flush to his right. Over the middle, the catch by Coleman. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. 14 yards is the pickup there, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
A good drive gets him inside the 5, but they could not punch it in.
And credit the defense, too. Make sure that happens, because that was the old bend but don't break approach. made sure they contained them when they absolutely had to, and forced the field goal attempt that went through.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. Patriot football again, and this team, so funny. Seems like we have this conversation every week, every year, but they started 1-2.
Oh, my.
Oh, my.
Oh, my.
Look, we talked about this last week. We knew that they would pick it up, and they have. They've won four straight this past week, beating the Bears 38-31.
Yeah, but not a normal 38-31, because the way that finished with the Bears having a chance to win the game, or at least get it tied with the Hail Mary, but still a win, and they did it without Gronk. He didn't even make the trip for this one. Sony Michel, their rookie runner, maybe on the shelf for a while. They're hoping it won't be for too long. The Patriots, though, they scored 38 points or more four straight games. So guess what? Number 12, Tom Brady, still piloting one of the best offenses in the league.
So second and eight here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down. Here's Brady. Wide open, it's Allen, complete. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. A gain of 32 that time.
I've got to make sure that I don't take Tom Brady's greatness for granted, that we make it routine. How about that throw right there?
Yeah.
Another great completion.
And you know one area where he honed his throwing? He was a catcher in high school. He was actually drafted by the Expos in 1995 in the 18th round.
Wow, that would have been something to see him behind the dish.
Think he gunned down a few guys?
Gunned down a few guys trying to steal second. That would have been fun to watch.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Grady Jarrett with the tackle.
Doubling this guy has to be a priority before moving up to the next level, because the big fella, he just ate that one alive, just stuffed it. In fact, before the game, he was talking to us, and he's like, hey, these pants make me look fat. And we said, nah, man, you're just a whole lot of guy.
He is at well over 300 pounds. He's a big man. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession. They'll run with Wayne, and he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
Early down stuffs have put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Throwing is Brady on third down. Trying to squeeze it into Edelman, and it's intercepted. It's Desmond Trufant. A big seam, and he might go all the way. And he takes this one back into the end zone, and the Falcon defense has a touchdown. I don't know who all is to blame there, but I love seeing pick sixes.
Nothing like seeing someone pluck it out of the air and go the other way and see people try to change directions. Hard to do.
Bryant tacks on the extra point, and the lead is now 10-7. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. That'll be taken in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right, Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now they may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Brady now on first down. And a dump off to White. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware, ball may come your way.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. From the gun, it's Brady. And he's going to find Hogan here, complete. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. And they just keep marching right along. First down on a pickup of 8 there. Brady, after the pick on the last drive, 3 for 3 to start this drive. It's first and 10. Here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
It's a tough one right there. He ran right into the teeth of the blitz as the linebacker was freed up in order to stuff that one for a loss. I think quarterbacks got to see that, got to find a way to audible into something a little more advantageous.
Brady to throw on second down. Buying time to his left. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
Sure, that pass was incomplete as they made an attempt to get a big one downfield. But that's okay because the second part of that is if you don't get the completion, at least you told the defense you're trying to stretch them out a little bit and they may have to change accordingly.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Shotgun now for Brady. And they'll get this to the 30-yard line before crossing over out of bounds. And they convert on third with a gain of 22. The former seventh-round pick, Julian Edelman, just continues to have such a productive career.
And has made himself into a receiver. Remember, he was a college quarterback, and not just a productive one, a very good one.
At Kent State, right?
Yes, a great leader, a guy who could make plays with his feet and his arm. Got to the NFL and had to convert into being a receiver and was drafted that way. And that conversion, oh boy, it's been good.
From Falcon territory now, here's first and 10 at the 30-yard line. Throwing on first down is Brady. And he's going to be taken down. Pressure gets there back at the 39-yard line. Brooks Reed in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Now Brady throwing on second down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. 1:58 to go in this first half of play. We're back to Atlanta right after this timeout. Brady now hitting on 80% of his passes in the early going. 8 of 10. It's first down. Into the red zone, it's Brady. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Vic Beasley in there to sack him for a loss of 6. And it's never good to take a sack. You really don't want to take one down here in this part of the field, down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. If you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost
under pressure again, and down he goes again. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here, as he'll talk it over here before what'll be an important third down. From the gun, it's Brady. And the pressure gets to him again. Brooks Wade in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
Brandon, what I remember most about playing with guys who knew how to rush the passer, they would just tell you, just cover people for me, just long enough for me to get there. And that's exactly what happened on that play.
And his kick is good. He got every bit of that one, as it's good from 56 yards out. A dozen plays on that drive that ends with the field goal.
Let's go ahead and break out some of the old chestnuts here, right, partner? Keep the ball in front, rally to it, and make the tackle. Right? No big plays given up. No balls over your head. Bend, don't break.
Hold on, hold on. Chestnuts?
You like that?
Come on. What does that mean, break out? Just because you break chestnuts?
I'm not sure about that, but I'm just going with why they said that. I have no idea.
Throw on first down with Ryan. Throw left side, complete. That's Coleman. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Give him 8 on the play, and it'll make it second down.
Hey, my way. Hey, express, express. Right. Left. Gotta go.
From the shotgun, Ryan. Escaping the pressure right, and he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
It's been my observation, there's been a nice variety of play calling defensively. You and I often talk about an offense's ability to keep a defense off balance with what they're doing. I think the converse has been true in this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They seem to have gone off tendency quite a bit, but only the second quarter, a lot of time to change things. Ryan. He finds Coleman. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. A solid gain of 15 yards, and the sticks move. Ryan now 6 of 10 in this first half. He's got his guys a first down here. Ryan will throw again. Looking left side, and he's got a man. It's Coleman. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it'll be a second down.
Hey, South, 20, 20.
Again, Ryan. Wide open receiver complete. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. A really good pickup of 28 yards. From the red zone now, here's Ryan on first down. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. Call it a loss of 14 on the play. And now it's second down. Throwing again, Ryan. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him, they've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He made his first attempt, this from 45. And Bryant's kick is good. And they will take the lead at 13-10. Now the drive ends in just three, but they'll take it. Looks like they'll head to the locker room, barring something unfortunate in front on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they may not be jumping up and down and celebrating because they have the lead, but still, any little momentum in a game like this is important to a team, and they'll feel real good about going in and regrouping, knowing that they are out in front.
Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And the ball backed way up, so thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
On first down, Brady. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. And just like that, on we head to half number two. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. And now out come the Patriots. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there. Just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. Brady now on first down. Over the middle, Julian Edelman. It's complete. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
I'm guessing, partner, that if we're in the huddle with the Patriots right now, there's not a single guy that thinks they have any chance of coming back in this one, especially not with Tom Brady.
Yeah, who's Tom Brady? What's he done in the past as far as comebacks are concerned? Yeah, down right now, but that can evaporate quickly with him in the huddle. On second down, here's Brady. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Tech McKinley in there to pick up his second sack now of the afternoon. Tough spot for the Pats now after the sack as Brady will lead him up third and long.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
It's complete. Swings it out to his running back. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Falcons will take control of the football in great field position. The fourth down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on first down. Now Ryan on first down. And he can't escape the pressure. Ryan goes down.
Partner, the Mike linebacker, the middle linebacker, has so many different responsibilities. How excited do you think he was to get home with that blitz?
Yeah, he wants a sack. He got it. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll bring this one inside the 35. Big play coming up. Here's third and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
They're back now to the original line of scrimmage thanks to that 8-yard gain. Third down now to follow. And the blitz does come. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. You can tell they were hoping for a flag there offensively. Several on the sideline motioning. Hey, why not a penalty? Why not a penalty? What did you see?
Yeah, I think you've got to let them play. And the officials are instructed, if there's contact coming from both sides, no flag. Let them fight it out.
And forces fourth down. So three field goals that he's hit. Now this last one helps him stretch out the lead.
He's been solid, hasn't he? And he lives up to the adage that every offensive coach has ever said to us. We want to end every possession with a kick, right? For them, it's either extra point, field goal, or at worst, a punt. In this case, it's been threes.
And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line. The Patriot offense now set to come back out onto the field. Brady and the Patriots now first and 10 at their 35-yard line. They'll start the drive with a give to White. And he's across the 40, three extra yards to the 43. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a second and 3.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
They keep it on the ground, White again. And he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
At this stage of the game, the run-pass numbers are a little bit out of whack because most of the yardage is coming through the air. But in a sense, that just sets things up for big runs like that because the defense might be a little bit off balance. They pick up another first down with that run.
The completion good for 3, and it's second down. That first down completion only netted him 3. Second and 7. Operating from the gun, Brady. The throw left side complete to Hogan. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. The reception good for 7. It's third down. New England on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get nothing out of that one. Call it no gain that time, and they're going to be left looking up at a 4th-and-1. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
And now before they run this play on 4th-and-1, we're going to get a break and a timeout. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Feeling like they're not quite in field goal range yet, they're going to go for it on 4th. They'll go for it. It's Brady. And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Patriots come up empty on 4th down. And the Falcons' defense stands tall. They'll get the football back. Well, we got a second here, Charles. Let's look back to some of those crazy finishes in Week 7 of the NFL last week. I mean, it seemed like every game had a wild finish.
It certainly did. Dallas, Washington, Brett Maher off the upright from 52 yards following a questionable penalty against his long snapper to move the ball back 5 yards. How about Cleveland-Tampa Bay? Cleveland claws his way back in, and then Tampa Bay wins the ball game with Chandler Catanzaro kicking the big field goal from 59 yards in overtime. Remember, he missed a 40-yarder in regulation. Justin Tucker missed an extra point. That's the headlines in and of itself, his first miss in the NFL, and New Orleans gets away with a victory. And New England-Chicago. Chicago throws the Hail Mary at the end of the game. Kevin White, 54 yards. He needed 55.
Yeah.
Stopped at the 1 yard.
I don't think I've ever seen a Hail Mary come that close but not get in. A really nice gain of 25 yards.
And the key number on that play, 3. Third play of the drive, 3rd down. Spectacular catch. Turns into a 1st down.
1st down saves him from a 3-and-out. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Falcons. They've got the football. They've got the lead as we get set to start the 4th. A fake to Freeman. Now it's Ryan. Eluding the pressure right. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Hall. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes and they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air, and sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it, and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there as they were able to connect. And Bryant's kick is good. And that will make this a 9-point lead. A big one there. That gives him a little cushion and makes it a 2-score game.
Yeah, bled a little time off the clock, put some points on the board. It's not totally out of reach yet, but it has to feel pretty good to them right now because as a defender, you go out on the field and say, guess what? You can put some points on the board, but that won't beat us.
So the Patriots coming out now. And on that last drive, went for it on fourth, turned it over. But good job by their defense, though. They held them to 3, but this offense, they've got to be a little bit better, a little bit more careful here.
And sometimes when you see these calls on fourth down, when they decide to go for it, it's not necessarily the coach saying, I believe in my offense. Sometimes the coach saying, I believe in my defense. I can afford to go for it here, because if we don't get it, I don't think we'll give up more than 3. And that's exactly what happened there.
You think that factored in?
I do. I think that he had that in his mind going into the game, that I'm going to be aggressive on offense because I know I've got a defense that can hold up their end.
To throw on second down. Brady goes underneath here to White. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. Give him 3 on the play, and that'll bring up a third down. From the gun, Brady. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Tech McKinley able to disrupt yet another pass play, his third sack of the afternoon. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now Brady, got to have this one. And he's going to go down again. Tech McKinley, who else? He's in there for his fourth sack of the afternoon. So still over 3 minutes remaining in this game, but boy, not getting that one, that hurt.
That's a little bit demoralizing, so they have to be careful about that because still have an opportunity if they can get some things done on defense. But now, since they've taken over on downs, a team with the ball, guess what? Going to 4-minute offense, maybe they can put this thing away.
That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Brandon, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter.
This is caught. It's Sanu this time for a Falcon touchdown. Mohamed Sanu from 19 yards away, and the Falcons will add on to their lead. Bryant's extra point up and good. And that could be important as that makes this a 16-point lead. Now here's Bryant to kick it away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. He gets away from one. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The Patriots offense now, they work their way back onto the field. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complimentary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. And Brady's throw there, incomplete from the 21. It's second and 10. Looking back to the air on second down, it's Brady. And this is incomplete. The safety, Keanu Neal, there to knock that one free.
When I watched that play, I thought about what my coaches had told me in the past, the biggest teaching point, get your head around. Locate the football so you can make a play on it while it's in the air. That's exactly what he did there. That was nice.
Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. operating from the gun. Brady. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Tech McKinley in there yet again. My goodness, make it 5 sacks for him now in this one game alone. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That's going to leave him with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. Here's Ryan Allen now, as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, and that could have been trouble.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it, he loses it. Somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
Atone for his sin, and you know he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. Ryan will bring the Falcons up now, first and 10 at their own 12-yard line. Now Ryan. Way there to burn some clock. That was wild. And at the end of all that, it winds up a safety. All right, Charles, help me out here. Fourth quarter, you've got the lead, and you run backwards into the end zone. You're just trying to do too much.
I almost don't have words for it. But you know, every coach that we talk to talks about running backs or people running the football, running north-south, getting upfield. He went way in the opposite direction. And that's going to cost his team.
Yeah, it cost him big time. Still leading, but it costs him. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. They go play action here on first down. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. Clearly wasn't outside of the tackle box. There's your penalty.
And accompanying that penalty, a loss of down.
They lose the yardage, and of course they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly second and long. Now Brady over the middle, complete. That's Gordon, and he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. That one good for 10 yards, and that's going to lead to a third and 12. Now Brady. And that's going to be too high. Out of bounds and incomplete.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. Expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Vic Beasley in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon. Ryan wants to throw it. And he's going to be taken down here. A sack back at the 32.
Okay, was it a breakdown in protection? Did the running back not pick him up? What does it really matter? Sometimes it's just a great play made by the defense. Big time sack.
So after the sack here, second and 14. Here's Ryan to throw. And finding the tight end Hooper. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. That catch good for 5. It's third down.
And, partner, I think that's a great example that not all tight ends are created equal, because everything was right. Got the completion, but he's not one of the more dynamic guys in the league. So even though he caught it, couldn't turn it into much more.
And he'll be brought down inside the 20 at the 19. They get 7 there, but it brings up 4th. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him, and what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
They run, Devontae Freeman. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now Ryan on second down. This is caught. And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Julio Jones from 6 yards away. And the Falcons will extend their lead.
I've got a laugh here, and I really don't want to because the old school in me is not happy about this score this late, not necessary. But this is Madden, isn't it?
Yeah.
This is how it works.
Rub it in. Have a day.
I mean, what does it matter? These guys who are playing in this game, there are no feelings.
Exactly.
There.
They don't have to face the guy. Well, they might if they're in the same room going head to head.
But that's
the
about
virtual
it.
Guys on the screen don't have to face each other after this one.
In that case, run it up.
Wait, 20.
The drive starts with a run by White, and not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7. Seems pretty obvious defensively a key was stopping the run game. How have they done it so successfully?
To me, it seems that these guys really did a nice job of paying attention during the scouting report meeting. And you know, Brandon, when they do those, they talk about the top plays that these guys like to run, the best runs for the top running back. Those are the ones you focus on and want to take away, and they've done that pretty successfully in this game.
And Charles, you know what coaches always tell us. We want to win our home games. That much we know. We want to protect our home turf. They got that done in this one.
Exactly right. When you start a season, everyone's goal, win all of your home games, split your road games, and you're likely going to be in the playoffs. But when you win at home, boy, what a great feeling that is. You don't even mind if people are at your house when you get home after a win like that.